friend. Today we will see the lateral cut, the fabrication for the lateral cut in AutoCAD. Here in this 3D drawing you can see we have a lateral cut of 45 degree. One pipe I have shown in yellow and the other is in red. And you can see how the correct dimension are these. Look at this. Let's start the calculation for the lateral cut in 2D. We have a lateral cut pipe fabrication. The vertical pipe dia, for example, is 100 and the lateral degree we have 45, and the other pipe which will be connected with the vertical, it will be 80 mm. Now let's draw in 2D. This is the vertical pipe which is 100 mm dia. This is we are watching from the top. This is the top view actually. And this pipe is 80 mm of dia. The red is showing the center line. Let's start the side view. The same projections. This one is 45 degree. Yes. This is the other pipe. 80 mm. As I told you, in between we have 45 degree. Let's check from the center line or from the corner. Both are same. From this line to this line is 45. Now let's start the fabrication. Same method, the division method, we will apply here. For this area we need the lateral cut dimensions for the fabrication. Just draw a circle of 80 mm from one line to another line and divide into 16 pieces. As I told you, it should be 16, 20, 24, something like this. And again here the same division of 16. you know, this is from the top, and the other is we can see this area. Only this area, not the other side. The other side will be same. It's the mirror dimension. Here we can see only one side, and we can calculate only one side, and the other side and all dimension will be mirror. So let's mark all of them. But this one is my number one, because it's the top view, so only this side I can see from the side view. So I will mark only this side, not the other side. Again, you can mark them clockwise or anti-clockwise, it's up to you. We have a half circle, and the total division it will be only 9. It's only the half section which can see from the side view, like here, and from the top. From here, look, this one is my top, 1, 2, 3, 4. And the side view, only I mark them as anti-clock. So I'll repeat the same anti-clock here. Only at the half of circle, 9 is complete. I will cut unnecessary lines, and then I will copy the parallel lines for all the divisions, for this area only. For example, these all lines should be parallel, same like this. Cut from inside. Now where they are touching with the circle is end, all the lines. We need only the bottom lines. For example, 1, 9, 2, 8, 3, 7, 4, 6, and 5. So let's start. This division we need to do the same process, just copy these line, and all of these should be parallel at 45 degree. And here you can see we have one, this one is my number one, extra large line I can draw. Change the color one by one. For example, here this number 9 and number 1, I have the same color, so I mark them 1 and 9, and this perpendicular is a large line. We need to see where is touching with this the same color. So I will cut all these lines. Now 2nd and 8, number 2 and number 8, let's change the color. Now I mark them green and the same perpendicular from here. Also you can color green this perpendicular, and the other two lines should be 2 and 8. Now look where the green line is touching, it must be end here. I will cut by perpendicular line both the lines. Now the turn is 3 and 7. Just change the color. Yellow is already yellow, so let's change it as blue and draw the perpendicular line by XL. This perpendicular line should be blue as well, and number 3 and the number 7, let's mark them blue. Now where the blue line is touching with a perpendicular line, and cut again by perpendicular line. Delete it, and now the turn is 4 and 6. So again change the color. If you do not change the color, you can continue, but if you are new, then you may change the lines to avoid the mistake. From here again, the perpendicular line, and just you need to see where is touching and cut it by perpendicular line. Now remaining is only the last line, which is number 5. Perpendicular line, cut it from here. Now you can see this one is number 5. So we have done all the cuttings, and now match all of these edges with each other by a single line, same like this. And you can see your lateral cut is ready for the fabrication. For the fabricator, you need to point out from where he will start the cutting. So you can draw a perpendicular line from this edge about 100 millimeter from here. It will be too easy for the fabricator, so draw the perpendicular line. And now from here you can measure all of these lines. For example, this one is number 9. The number 9 is 100 millimeter, also you can make a table. It's very easy for the fabrications. Number 9 is not 100. I will add it. Just I need to make a table. This one is number 8. Number 8 is 106.44. You can make the table by measure from the perpendicular line to the edge. Same as you can see here. Table. The fabricator can fabricate easily from this table. For example, if we have a pipe in the same diameter and divide the pipe into 16 equal division, then from here same he can draw the perpendicular lines for each segment, and from the table if you draw a line, and this one is number 9, the 100 millimeter. Okay, this line is end here. You can see this one is my 100, this is number 9, and then number 8, number 7, number 6, number 5, from the bottom, not from the top. Start from the top, it's up to you, but keep the sequence in the same way, same like this, and the other one by one you can cut all of these lines, and if you match them together the lateral cut will be ready.